Good day, I'm your humble narrator, Sideways Thinker, and I'm just here with a brand new Let's Play. This time, it's of Overlord on the PC. Yes, Overlord, for those of you who are not aware, is a game I believe it was either developed or published, it's probably published, honestly, by Codemasters. I believe it was developed by Triumph Studios, I think that's right. I didn't check this, but this is just me hoping to Christ I remembered the credits correctly. But yes, Overlord is a third-person action game. It is action game with some mild RPG elements, and definitely a fancy RPG style in the way it looks. It's very much kind of a parody, an almost Dungeon Keeper-y parody of a fantasy universe. It's also been described in terms of its gameplay and being astoundingly similar to Pikmin. And having both played both Overlord and Pikmin, that is definitely a comparison that can be made. I've only ever played Pikmin once for about 3 hours, and I wasn't too keen on it, but that might just be, I don't know. I'm assuming it's a good game, because frankly, this takes a lot of its gameplay from Pikmin, but maybe just because I prefer the aesthetic that this game has. But yes, you play as the titular Overlord, and you run your little army of minions, and it's all quite good. As I say, this is the PC version. Now, the PC version is somewhat infamous for a couple of reasons. The main reason being that keyboard and mouse control with Overlord is abysmal, as far as I'm aware. I've never tried it myself, but I've heard a lot of bad things about trying to play this game with a mouse and keyboard, hence why I'm playing it with it using my... I'm playing this game... I'm going to be doing this Let's Play using my Xbox 360 PC controller-y thing. Which also helps because the other times when I played Overlord, it was always on the Xbox 360. This Let's Play is only going to be covering Overlord 1 and not Raising Hell, the expansion pack to Overlord, because while I have completed that several times, I don't have it on the PC. If I do get around to getting a copy, or if a copy was donated, if I somehow get my hands on a copy, basically, I will almost certainly continue this and do Overlord, Raising Hell. Depending on how much people like this. Also, depending on how much people like this, I might do the sequel. But that all remains to be seen. Anyway, let's just get into the game. Sorry about the long introduction. Because you know what I'm like. I like me long introductions. They always have to be at least 2 minutes long, otherwise I'm doing something wrong.
Rub some ash in his eyes. Master, evilness truly suits you. Let us go forth. There are nefarious deeds to be done. I feel the land quaking with fear already.
Also, I'm sorry if the audio isn't quite right. I'm still asking around with the
settings. I am Nal, minion master and devoted servant of darkness.
But yeah, as you can see here already, you can see it's third person, so.
And your muscles will become limber again.
Third person, and you can
sleep for a very long time.
And you can see right here, we're ever so slightly Sauron-ish looking Overlord. It's something I always noticed that, with the exception of this first armor, because obviously you can actually see the skin on his arm there, this character is very, very akin to Sauron in the way he looks, especially when you get to the higher level armors where, like, you're just entirely covered in all and plate and it's all spiky and shit. I imagine that's purposeful, you know, because Sauron is ever so slightly kind of, you know, the archetypal evil Overlord, so.
This cavern is the spawning pit, sire, where new minions are born and live. Now you are here, you can call forth minions from this minion gate.
Yes, the word minion is going to start sounding really fucking strange by the end of this.
Ah, look at those keen little evil faces, ready to loot and pillage at your command. Let us continue. Follow me if you wish to study the finer points of combat and minion control.
I probably should.
Of course, if you want to get straight to the smiting, then I shall meet you in the throne room upstairs.
You know what? I probably should go to the tutorial because
Your minions will follow you wherever you go, Master, unless you give them a task.
So I'm just trying to, because I know you can control the minions by using a thumbstick, so, but I can't quite figure out how to do that. You know what, screw it. I'll do the tutorial. I wasn't going to, but I don't know how to do the basic thing that you kind of have to do in this game in order to get anywhere, so.
Being Overlord is more than just throwing a few fireballs and causing chaos. Proper evil takes skill and maybe, well, just a bit of mayhem. I think the Sleeping Beauty's a little rusty. Oh, our jester, sire. I really should have nailed him out for the crows long ago. Teach him to respect his overlord.
Because of course these creatures, that only like two of them can speak proper English.
You're tickling! You're tickling!
Is going to be able... of course they need a jester. It's not like the one...
Now hit him again. Don't hold back.
It's not like they literally wouldn't be able to understand what he was frigging saying or anything.
See? It's all coming back now. Evil is not something you just forget. Come on, that's it. Now you've got him.
Okay, this isn't what I wanted to learn here, Noel. I know how to lock on to things. You taught me how to lock on to things moments ago. It's the same button.
Come on, princess. You move like a dead badger. Shame you don't smell as good. He's out of your reach, sire. Use your minions to shut his flapping mouth. Fire, Tubbs! They should call you the Oath. Oh, it warms my black heart to see them running about the place, trying to rip each other apart. Ooh. Call your minions back, Master. All of them.
Okay, you hold it. Okay.
Oi, Mr. Overlord! Show me some evil! If you need your minions to follow a complicated route, then you must sweep them through it.
Okay, there we go. It was exactly what I thought it was. It just wasn't letting me do it in the other area. But yeah, this is honestly the primary way I play the game, is I just sweep. I just use the sweep function to sweep minions through places. Oh, I can't actually go up there to destroy those mushrooms. Oh.
Call that evil? Overlord? Overrated, more like.
Yeah, there's a lot of very bad British accents in this game.
Get away, sire! Sweep your minions after him. Bet he'll whittle himself silly.
Well, okay, so you're just gonna teach me how? You're just gonna make me sweep again? You see, this isn't very impressive when you've only got three, but later on in the game, I think you can get like 50 minions at a time, so it becomes much more impressive very quickly.
I think you're ready, Master. Accompany me to the throne room. Evil deeds won't do themselves.
See what I mean when I say it's very dungeon keeper-y?
Beat him further if you wish.
Yeah, nah, I've got better things than to beat up the fucking jester. The jester, who I believe does attempt to fuck us over completely later on in the game, but that's not until I get that's not. But you'll only hear about that if I actually get to the expansion. Fuck me, this place is a fucking wreck.
Your throne room, sire.
Ah, fucking grand.
Alas, one cannot be a bastion of evil these days without wretched heroes lining up to prove themselves. That last lot were particularly bothersome, killing your predecessor like that. Still, you're here now, sire. Evil will always find a way. They also looted and destroyed much of the tower. But it's merely a setback for the forces of darkness, sire. You are our new overlord. Rebuild your tower, punish those so-called heroes, and re-establish a dark domain. This is the tower portal, sire. Sadly, it's missing its power source, the tower heart. However, there's still a tiny bit of energy left. It's just enough to transport you to the last known location of the heart.
A parody of the Shire.
When you're ready, sire, step...
When you're ready, sire, don't fucking go until I've finished my dialogue. I was paid to record this line, you know.
Ah, you made it through the gate, sire. This tranquil wilderness, so rural and idyllic. Hideous, is it not? Try not to inhale it, my lord. You can summon your minions from these gates. They are ancient arcane links between your tower and this land. Currently, you can only summon browns. You must find the other lost minion tribes before you can summon them.
Browns, who inexplicably
perhaps
are yellow.
Perhaps we may recover some of our looted tower objects in this lush, verdant abomination.
Something I've never been entirely certain what Gnarl is. Because, yeah, I know he's a minion, but
these
what
fluffy
kind?
Creatures barely know they're alive, but you can still harvest life force from them. Remember, life force equals minions. Return to the gate to call more to your side.
But yes, so then this game has really two resources. It has money, I believe mana later. Well, actually, no, three resources. No, okay, fuck it. Resources, not the like, character abilities.
Something beneficial. There's nothing minions like more than breaking things.
But yeah, the game really has three
apart
kinds of resources. those being life force that you get from killing enemies, and money that you get by breaking the enemy's stuff. Life force of, I believe there's four varieties, blue, green, red, and yellow, or brown as the game insists on calling it. Each corresponds to the different varieties of minion, only one of which we currently have, but I think it's not too long until we get the second variety, which is fire. Each of the minions serves a different purpose. Of course. We've only got three minions, so we need to summon another two. See, there, we've got our current maximum, which is five. Not exactly an impressive force, but there you go. Depressingly, there was nothing... Shut up. Depressingly, there was nothing in those urns that the minions could pick up. Because if the when you break things, you either find money, health and mana items, or items that your minions can use. And the items, they're partly cosmetic. They also just make the minions generally stronger and more well able to defend themselves.
Make your master proud. Onward!
Oh! Halflings took over my farm! Toyed me up in the sun to scare the birds! Now, those pumpkins are plotting against poor Bob. They want revenge for all the pies I made. And the soup. And the jelly. And the, ice cream. I hear the pumpkins whispering at night. But I won't leave my farm to the halflings. Oh no! They're worse than the pumpkins! Please help get Bob's farm back. Your creatures ain't related to pumpkins, are they?
Not exactly the most evil overlordish thing to do. That's kind of a common criticism about this game, is that it...
They're scared. Get them! Get them!
Kind of a common criticism of this game is the fact that it goes on and on about evil and... Oh, look, it seems like two of them have found pumpkins to put on their heads.
Even the birds laugh at me. They're in league with the pumpkins.
But, yeah, there's that common criticism of this game, of the fact that it bleats on about, oh, well, you gotta be evil, you gotta evil will always find a way, is like the tagline of the series, and yet, inexplicably, you spend most of your time helping people. you're always the lesser of two evils, you're not actually the ultimate evil. Even in the game as a whole, you're not the ultimate evil, but that's a bit of a spoiler.
That showed him! Oh, you'd better get going, Sonny. The path behind my house leads to the village of Spree. Oh, I bet there are more of them fat little demons about, so be careful.
Yeah, this entire area is kind of a parody of the area of Hobbiton and the areas around Hobbiton. I mean, to the point at which the human village is called Spree, as in, you know, Bree, I believe it was called in Lord of the Rings.
Yeah, don't talk so much. Yeah, that'd be nice.
Go on, you little yellow bastards, pick
minions
up some stuff.
Will automatically equip any useful items they find. And often, any useless items too. But do not fear, your weapons and armor are custom forged at the tower. We wouldn't dream of giving you any old steal-me-downs. No.
Yeah, because that wouldn't exactly strike fear into the hearts of men, would it? If, the Overlord is walking around wearing, carrying a fucking hobbit shield, just because it's the fucking hobbit's shield, just because it's the one thing that's actually worth a damn to him at the moment. Kill him!
See the clouds that rose from those dead halflings? That's evil energy. It gathers in all us evil creatures. You will learn more of it in time, Master.
Do you know what I mean? The main people we're fighting are,
The Tower Heart. The halflings must have used it to grow pumpkins. The little fools. They have no idea of the real power it contains. Clear those pumpkins and let's get it back to the tower.
And there are actually some level of moral choices in this game that can determine, you know, how evil you are. But whereas Overlord 2, frankly, I think worked with this, with the concept of the whole evil thing better than Overlord 1 did. For the simple reason that in Overlord 2, you're evil no matter what you do. Whereas in this game, it's kind of almost a Fable-esque. Frankly, this series has always reminded me a lot of Fable. And yes, there are camera control issues, because obviously one of the thumbsticks is constantly going to be dedicated to moving minions. Oh shit, no way. I can't actually have them move that yet. Yeah, I need to knock that down first. But yeah, this game's very Fable-y as well. You might have picked up on that. Very much in its art design and in just the kind of the parody fantasy world, it's very much like Fable. Like Fable 1. Because we don't talk about the rest of the series. We talk about Fable 1 and Fable the Lost Chapters, and the rest of the series never happened. The minions have found a shortcut. They wouldn't have found shit if I hadn't opened it up.
Moldy, keep up with the other minions. Giblet, I see you pretending to hold it with one claw. Hold your share, Gubbin, you useless sack of pus.
Because, of course, they've got these really ridiculous names that makes them sound like the fucking Unsullied. I think that should... No? Oh. Oh, we have to go back to the tower. Okay.
You should return to the tower side.
Sorry, my controller's acting up. There we go. Sorry, the controller does that from time to time. It's because the USB ports in the front of my PC are fucked, so it kind of acts up every now and again. I really do need to get that looked at.
It's back where it belongs. This is the heart of the tower, sire. It will play a vital role in helping re-establish your dark domain. It will allow you to visit the tower whenever you wish and provide access to all of the tower's resources. And look, it seems to have bestowed a little gift upon you, sire. You can now control 10 minions. Ha! And it seems to have retained one of its spells. The fireball spell. Robust fellow. Might have known he'd make it. I'll teach you how to use him when the need arises. But I urge you, sire, find more of our missing tower objects. A crane would be particularly handy. Then we could clear the debris around here, open up some rooms. Unfortunately, I am not the evil entity that I once was. I cannot take the feel of lush green grass under my feet and birdsong in my ears. In fact, I think I need to find a dark corner and something to pummel. I shall stay here. The heart will allow me to speak directly to you, sire, and see and hear what you do. Use the gate to return to the halfling domain.
It's gotta be said, I've never fully been able to understand exactly how it is that anyone managed to invade this place, because you go over here, right, and you can actually look at the place that surrounds us, and it's nothing but these horrible jagged mountains. Like, this place doesn't appear to have anything connected to it. Yeah, you have to go back to Mellow Hills. But yes, so we just got there, we got the tower heart, and thus begins...
Testing! Oh, there it is. 1, 2... Is this thing working? It's a bit grubby. Can you hear me, Master? There you are. And now, sire, the creatures around here are rather frisky, so they will have undoubtedly repopulated the area.
That I'm just telling you about the fact that there's no persistence between how many between the creatures that you kill.
Spree! revolting name. Thank you.
Right there, we have another minion tower, another minion command piece. However, we can't access that one because we need the blue minions that we don't get for quite some time. Yeah, the game is kind of built around that. If you want to be very, if you want to kind of succeed and get all you can in the game and be as powerful as you can be in the game, you kind of need to, you need to come back and revisit places. And frankly, given the way that the game works, if you're not particularly good at the game, like I've never been particularly good at this game. I've never been particularly strategic with the way that I manage my minions. If you're not particularly good at the game, you kind of need to go back regularly to earlier areas, specifically Spree. In my case, because my favorite minion type is the old browns. In order to just farm them, is just to farm the creatures for more life energy. And of course, my controller's just fucked up again. My apologies. It just happens a few times.
Approaching. Get ready.
Hang on. Those ain't halflings. Look at the one with the helmet.
Could be two halflings holding up some armor. Yeah, I bet that's it. I don't trust those sneaky little wasp names.
Maybe you're right. Here, prove you ain't halflings and free our men from the camps down the road.
Bizarrely, we are still...
Stay right there I can get my aim straight.
There, in the field. Greedy little halflings. Use your fireball spell on the wheat and roast them like suckling pigs.
Okay, there we go. Let's see if we can't do this. There we go. Roasty toasty halfling. Bit grim, if I'm honest. Little grim. Go on, lads, get the life essence. Grab what weapons they dropped. Hang on, out of that entire group, only one of them dropped any bloody life energy. Christ, a halfling's not human. A halfling's not human. That's a great sentence. Quick, lads, jump them! Jump them! Excellent, you managed to jump them and get the gold. Just what I like to see. We have, however, burnt that entire field, so there that is. Yeah, you can see here at this point already, we're not the big evil here. And we never will be. The big evil here is the halflings. Which is a bit odd, that, you know, fucking Frodo Baggins and company is apparently on par with Satan in this world, isn't it? Also, just as a note, you can actually get involved in the fighting, but I just tend to choose not to. For the simple reason that you're not particularly good at fighting.
Killing innocents, and I use the term loosely, increases your corruption level. This attracts more evil energy, which increases your powers. However, this is rarely suitable for establishing a long-term evil plan. That requires people, living people. Gratitude comes with its own rewards.
Yeah, you see, here's where it introduces the moral choice system. Now, this doesn't make much sense in this game. As I say, it makes more sense in Overlord 2. Because in Overlord 2, no matter what you're doing, you are being evil. In this one, you're literally... just basically being an evil-themed hero, or you're being a sadistic murdering maniac. Whereas in Overlord 2, it is literally you are either being an evil tyrant or a murdering psychopath. This game tries to pass it off as you're being a murdering psychopath or an evil tyrant, but you're not really doing anything tyrannical. You are literally just kind of showing up and helping them, which. Never really struck me as the most evil overlordish behavior, but that's why I always play this and go for corruption rather than gratitude, because gratitude does mean that, you know, later on there's more resources. I think it just means there's constantly spawning resources in certain areas, but there's still constantly respawning resources if you go with evil as well. If you go with corrupted, they're just less of them, but they still respawn.
Be careful, Lord.
It means you get them more
this
quickly.
This is an arcane blood pit, sire. You can sacrifice minions here to regain your own health. Have no fear. Your minions will gladly die for you. They're very loyal.
They're throwing rocks. Primitives!
So it struck me as odd that the minions would describe anyone else as primitive. Oh god, we've had our first death. Yes, the minions can, in fact, die. And later on in the game, you can see there's got a little sign there, which just broke off, which means he's actually dead. But yeah, later on in the game, you can, I believe, actually resurrect them. I think it's the blues that are capable of that. The blues can resurrect the other minion types.
Look, sire, a wheel. Your minions can turn these and, well, you never know what might happen.
You never know what might happen, except for the fact that you can quite clearly see what's going to happen. So I just get a bit of a murdering done. If I recall correctly, these guys will just keep spawning and attacking you forever, basically.
Might be short, but they're tough.
For some reason, there's just something, I've always just liked the image of, you know, a little army of minions. I believe, and I may be wrong about this, that it's around this point that the demo for this game actually ended. I only know this because I played the demo for this game to an absurd degree. I really played this game's demo fucking constantly while I was waiting for the game to come out because I was quite excited for this game. Here we have just another inexplicable area where they've just put a bunch of sheep. Which again, I think that's why this area... Spree and the areas around Spree are literally just fucking... The Mellow Hills level is just basically designed for you to farm browns. Which is fair enough, I suppose. It's one of the earliest areas in the game, so... Can't really blame him. Okay, I think there's actually a tower object somewhere near here. I don't want to go through there yet. I want to save that for the next episode. So, we're going to quickly have a bit of a looky look here. Because I think there's either a tower object or there's a shortcut. Oh, there we have a mana pool. Same as the health pool, just gives you mana. Yeah, here we go. We got a shortcut leading right back to
a mana pit. Oh, I haven't seen one of these in years. They allow you to sacrifice your minions and replenish your mana.
I think there's a tower object here, but I may just be remembering the yellow thing. But I could have sworn there was another one you can get. No, it's me going insane. It's just that one which you need the blues in order to get. Ah well. You can, as you can see there, you can just return to tower from anywhere in the game, however it will kill all of your minions, and frankly these guys are relatively well equipped, so I don't particularly want to go killing them. Bizarrely, I think it's this game, it might be in Overlord 2, but you can oddly give your minions, you can bring them back, you can pay a certain amount of life essence, a life force, in order to bring them back from the dead, which always took me as a bizarre thing to want to do, because they don't. Because minions as a whole, they've got some level of personality, but individual minions fucking don't. The only way I could ever think of that being conceivably something you'd want to do is if, say, a minion had a unique hat. Like, that's it. Like, if they got a special hat. Which can happen, because I think there are, like, several... I think several of the bosses do drop items that you can only get the once from that boss, and that's
Welcome.
It. Just gotta... Sorry, give me a minute. I just gotta kick the shit out of this annoying little turd. But, yeah, so that's it for part one of this Let's Play of Overlord. Next time, we will be going into the Halfling camps in order to rescue the people of Bree, because... Spree, because inexplicably, this guy... Just drink this in for a moment. This guy is the hero. For some strange reason. But don't worry, I'm going to be doing a lot of corrupter acts in order to get rid of that. Also, is he wearing a minion skull? But yes, so that's going to be all for me for now. I've been your Lord Cyrus Thinker, and as always, keep calm and carry on. Good day.